Hey everybody, this is Gary, and as you know, my channel is Gary DeFinis LPI. LPI stands for Licensed Private Investigator. So let me give you some background on this. I'm going to do four video clips here relating to some situation that happened. Anyhow, in this clip, all right, this is the ex-husband of my client. And he has a restraining order against them. They've been divorced for at least a year now. They have a couple children together. There is a custody order. He's supposedly not supposed to be around the children at all. But the point is he's got a restraining order. And this is the wife's house. Okay? So, the wife has been afraid of this guy for some time now. And she installed lots of cameras. And she also has a new boyfriend of about 6 months, half a year, that's been living with her. All right. So the husband, apparently, with the restraining order, takes a cab or an Uber or something to the wife's house, and he breaks into the home, or at least he comes right into the house. All right. So here's video one of four clips. Here he is, running up to the house, going right into the front door. All right, so we see that. Now, let me get out of this and go to video number two, which is over here. And let me pause that real quick because I want to widescreen it. This is shortly after the video number one, coming right into the house and running in. Now, there's kids home. He's got a restraining order against the against the children too. He's not allowed to be around the children, not around the ex-wife. All right, let's see this again. Here's a restraining order video. Comes right in the house. He was not invited to the home, and he runs straight in. He knows this place. He knows the layout of it. All right, because he's lived here. All right. This is the kind of situation you can get into. Now we're going to go to number three. The boyfriend is home, and he's sitting on the couch watching TV. So let's pause that and make it into a large screen. And the boyfriend has to be commended big time, because watch what he does when this guy invades their home. Now, the kids run out of the house. The wife's calling the police. Poor dog is standing right there. Now, the boyfriend runs up the steps, from my understanding, grabbed his gun, and fired it in the house into the ceiling, not at the subject, to give him a warning to get him to get out of the property. But look how he beats his ass. This is crazy. I mean, awesome for the boyfriend. He's protecting his house. He lives there. He's protecting his girlfriend. He's protecting the children. He could have killed the guy if he wanted to, but he didn't. He did the right thing. And just as a follow-up, the suspect, I believe, is still in jail. All right. He's going to have a long list of things he's got to go for. Let's look at that again. Start from there. Well, let's start from here. There he goes. Boyfriend kicks his ass. I mean, the guy got a couple good punches in, but now the boyfriend's just wailing at him. I love that he's got an American flag on his shirt. He did the right thing. It's the home invader who did the wrong things. Let's watch him get his ass kicked again. This is awesome. But the reason I'm showing you these videos, because this is what happens in these situations, these domestic situations. I mean, you're talking about this guy with the hoodie is divorced. He's got restraining orders against him from the wife, from the children, and he still showed up. Came right into their home, dropped his cell phone on the floor, if you notice that, and then got his ass whooped. Let's see if he picks up the cell phone. That'd be interesting, because that would place him there as well. I see this, the homeowner. Yeah, he left his cell phone there. Huh? What a jerk. Let's watch it one more time. And then there's a video clip 4 where the homeowner was running up the steps, I guess, of the house and went to get his gun, but there's no real activity on that. So, I mean, this is home invasion 4. You can see the homeowner, he runs up the steps or something here. There he is, gone. And then the guy's trying to come up there after him. There he is. See, he's coming right up after him. And then that's pretty much it with that clip. I mean, let's rewind it a little bit. Maybe we can get a good view of him. Try to pause it. So for you ladies out there who get restraining orders, I mean, it's really serious. These guys, they're narcissists. They're all kinds of things. I mean, it's hard to describe, but this guy came back into the house of his ex-wife and was fighting the boyfriend, who's taking care of his kids, by the way. That's a shame. The kids were there. They had to, my understanding is the kids were there and they had to witness their dad do this. What a scary situation. So maybe he'll go to jail and be whatever. Correct. Maybe we'll get some counseling or something. So let's go through all 4 real quick. 1. Coming into the house. 2. Walking into the house. I mean, this guy knows cameras are there. 3. Fighting. Coming into the house, into the living room. Thank God the boyfriend was smart enough to know how to fight himself. You know, he's defended his home, defended his family. Well, and then 4, going up the steps and the crazy man chasing him. Just want to give you a good idea. All right, so if you have any issues with restraining orders, you know, not a bad idea to get these cameras installed all over your house. And I know most people don't like having cameras, but in this situation... Oh, and by the way, the perp in this case stole their car, right? And took off. He took their keys and took off. And from my understanding is the police caught him down the road. And he is currently locked up. So, I can't stop watching this video. I love it. It's awesome. All right, if you like this video, please hit the like button. Subscribe to this channel if you haven't done so already. And God bless America. And remember, where we go one, we go all. Peace.